I'm Jaylee.
And I'm Anastasia, and here are your morning announcements.
If you are interested in learning more about how your brain works, come join the Psychology Club. The first interest meeting will be September 21st from 2:20 to 3 o'clock in room C311.
All those interested in joining the boys' basketball team should join the Google Classroom for updates on strength and conditioning, Google Meets, and tryouts. The classroom code is EORFBVB.
Anime Club will be held on the first and third Thursdays of every month in S211 starting at 2:10. The first meeting will be Thursday, September 23rd. Our class code is AWWP7L2.
It's not too late to be part of the CHS Fall Play. It will be a fun comedy show that you will not want to miss. If you're interested, join the Google Classroom code 6TN6S4V.
Are you interested in esports games? Join the Google Meet with the code WVAUBG7.
Do you enjoy history, filmmaking, web design, or the performance arts? Then the National History Day Club might be the right for you.
If you are interested, join the Google Classroom with the code 465NUZE. The first mandatory club meeting will be Wednesday, September 15th at 2:20 in E302, or you can join the Google Meet in our Google Classroom.
Join the Academic Decathlon team. They meet every Monday in South 313 after school. If interested, contact Mr. Stewart or come to a meeting. The classroom code is 2I6NGBI.
Anyone interested in playing ice hockey this year should join the Google Classroom with the code VR2CTJX or email code Sanisuso at msanisuso@cliftonschools.net.
Hey CHS, the Games Club is back. If you like checkers, chess, Uno, or any kind of tabletop games besides video games, then join the Games Club. Google Classroom code is LMAAZSN.
Seniors, Laura sent out emails to the senior class so you can make an appointment to get your senior portrait taken.
Senior portraits are September 20th through October 1st. It will be taken in the Media Center starting at 3 o'clock. Please direct all senior portrait scheduling and login questions to Lors at customerservice@lorsstudio.com or call the number down below.
Next, we continue with our new segment on the morning news dedicated to the PBSIS. Today's PBSIS segment will focus on our pillar of respect and our expectations for the hallways, stairs, and the restrooms.
Hi CHS, my name is Ms. Wint and I'm a special education teacher here at school.
What's up CHS? My name is Mr. Sars and I am a history teacher here at the high school.
To us, respect means showing consideration for other points of view and how your words and actions will affect other people. When we are respectful, we value each other's point of view even if we disagree. When we are respectful, we are polite and kind and treat each other with dignity. I see students being respectful all the time at CHS. Here are a few examples that stand out for me. Listening when someone is talking to you, asking before touching or taking another person's belongings, social distancing and wearing a mask, accepting other people's differences, saying I'm sorry, playing fair, and showing concern, cooperating with adult directions, and being on time for class.
I'm here to talk to you a little bit about the expectations. So look, rule number one here at CHS is to make sure that you have your ID on at all times. It needs to be around your neck and visible. I'll be honest with you, you won't get very far if that's not the case. You should also have a hall pass with you. That's basically your ticket to wherever you're going. When walking in the hallway, it is important that you stay to the right. This is especially true when it is in between periods. Like in most schools you have probably been to, we have up and down staircases. Please follow them like that. And don't be that person who, you know, goes up the down or vice versa. You should do what you gotta do and then return to class in a timely manner. You need to be aware that only one student is allowed out of a class at a time. So you should be respectful of your classmates and not mess around when you're out in the hall pass. Most importantly, if you see something or hear something that you don't think is right or you think it's unsafe, please report it to the nearest staff member.
And that's all we have for you today.
Have a happy
National Hug Your Dog Monday.
She told me.